Good morning to all of you. Today is our first lecture for the first module, Principle of Measurement, Testing and Measuring Instrument. In this lecture, we are introduced the concept of generalized measurement system, then concept of accuracy, precision, linearity, sensitivity, resolution and hysteresis and calibration. Before going to the generalized measurement system, we define some terms, basic terms related to the measurement system. First is a measurement. Measurement, it is an act or result of a quantitative comparison between predetermined standard and unknown magnitude. So we can see the measurement is a process between comparison between two quantities. One is a known quantity and second one is an unknown quantity. Known quantity which is to be standardized and unknown quantity which is to be measured. Second one is a measurement. A physical quantity or the characteristic condition which is the object of the measurement is an instrumentation system termed as a measurement. So simply in short form we can say that the condition or object in which is to be determined or compared with the standard known quantity, that is called as measurement. Measurement may be, there are two types, fundamental quantity and derived quantity. The fundamental, it may be example of length, mass and time. Derived quantity, example speed, velocity and acceleration or pressure. So here the generalized block diagram of a measurement system. So we can say that there is a component, there are the four blocks which the generalized measurement system consists. First block, detector establishment stage. Second block, intermediate modifying stage. Third block is a display and fourth block is power supply. Detector stage, where the physical quantity which is to be measured are applied at the transducer stage. In this, any measurement system directly not sense the quantity. For example, if we measure the temperature, that time we cannot be applied to the directly in instrument. It is sensed by the temperature sensor, then it converted into a particular format of the signal and transmitted to the intermediate stage. Intermediate stage are nothing but it consists of signal conditioning devices like recorders, preamplifiers, etc. So here the analog receive signal are recorded, it may be modified, it will be decreased or increased, or it may be stored, or various processes will be done. This, the output of the intermediate state is fed back to the display devices. It may be indicated by the pointer and it may be displayed on a digital indicator in numerical format, or the output of this intermediate signal will be used for the control purpose by the appropriate controller. And last block is nothing but power supply. The whole things are consist of the small electronic circuit. To provide the excitation of this electronic device or circuit, we require a power supply. So power supply provide the excitation to the all other blocks. This is the generalized measurement system. So basic characters, why we select a particular instrument to measure any value, how to select this particular instrument? This instrument can be selected with the help of their characteristics. What are the characteristics? The characteristics are help to select a particular instrument to measure a particular quantity. So performance characteristics, we can say that in two terms, static characteristics and dynamic. So static means which does not change or it may be constant or very slowly with the time, and dynamic which rapidly vary with the quantities or which may be the change with the time. So what are the static characteristics of instrument? Accuracy, precision, linearity, sensitivity, resolution, hysteresis, calibration, error, scale, range or scale plan, repeatability and reproducibility. So first we define accuracy. It is the degree of closeness with which the instrument can predict approaches value quantity to be measured. Or we can it is the exactness of the measurement compared with the expected value. Accuracy is the ability of instrument to show exact reading. So simply we can say it is a degree of closeness with which the instrument can approach its true value. So that is called as accuracy. Precision. It is a measure of the consistency of reliability of the measurement. We can say that in simple word, the precision is nothing but the instrument can repeat same reading or same indication will be shown after each and every time. That is called as a precision. An equipment which will be precise is not necessary to be accurate. So here we can define that from the example how the precision and accuracy. First figure show high accuracy, high precision. Second figure show low accuracy, low precision. Sorry, high precision. And third figure show low accuracy and low precision. Linearity. It is an ability of instrument to reproduce its input linearly. If it is normally desirable, the output reading of instrument linear proportional to the quantity. For example, VI characteristics of the diode are linearly. Whenever the input current increases, the voltage also increases. So the linearity is the proportionality of input and output. Sensitivity. It is the ratio of change in output of instrument to the change in input. Our smallest change is major variable to which the instrument can be response. The sensitivity can be defined as well. Infinitesimal change in output, infinitesimal change in input. The sensitivity of instrument must be high. So smallest change in output can be detected by the instrument. That property is called as a sensitivity of an instrument. Resolution. It is the smallest change in a measurement variable to which the instrument will be respond. The smallest change of input or will be the change in output. When the input is slowly increased, the arbitrary non-zero input value observed does not change. So that is called resolution. Then hysteresis. Hysteresis, when the input of instrument is gives some output reading, but with decreasing with the same input, the different reading. So this effect is called as a hysteresis. Basically, difference between two curves which is termed as hysteresis means they are does not follow the proportionality ratio. That is called as a hysteresis. And the main reason of the hysteresis, friction, mechanical flexure of internal part and electrical capacitor. These are the sources. Calibration. Calibration is a process of checking by comparison with the standard the accuracy of measuring instrument of any type. It also includes the adjustment of the instrument to bring it into alignment with the standard. Error. Measurement error is defined as the difference between true or actual value and measured value. True value is the average or infinite number of measurement, and measured value is a precise value. So error can be classified into gross, systematic, random. Again, the systematic, instrumental, environmental and observation, and instrumental error, these are the sources for the instrumental error. So absolute error, true value minus measured value. Relative error, it is the ratio of absolute error divided by true value. And percentage error is 100 into relative error. That can be defined as the your percentage error. This is an example. We can clear how to calculate the error. Then dynamic characteristics of the measurement system. They are the category of four: speed of response, fidelity, lag, and dynamic error. So what is the speed of response? It is defined as the rapidly with the which the measurement system responds to change in a measurement quantity. So that is the speed of response. So fidelity, it is the capability of the system faithfully reproducing change in input without any error. That is called as fidelity. Then lag. Measuring lag, it is the retardation or delay in the response of a measurement system to change the quantity. that is called as a lag. So it is a delay or retardation in a response by the instrument in measurement system. There are the two types. One is the retardation type and second is the time delay type. So in this retardation type, the instrument or measurement system being immediately after the change in a measurement quantity will be occur. Means response is very fast. In time delay lag, the response of the measurement system being after date time, the application of the dynamic error. It is a difference between true value of the quantity changing with the time and the value indicated measurement system. If there is no static error is assumed, it is called as a measurement error. Then in this lecture we have completed the generalized measurement system, how to select a particular measurement system to measure a particular unknown quantity with the help of their static and dynamic characteristics. So here we will stop. Thank you. Thank you.